The intention was to only stop scrolling through Instagram for one day, but I ended up not using any social media for one whole week. Let me explain what happened. You know how everyone keeps talking about mental health and taking a break from social media? I never really felt the necessity to do that until a couple of weeks ago. I'm not even active on any social media to begin with, but I scroll through Instagram a lot. On one hand, I felt like I needed to stop using Instagram so much, and my phone generally. It's like I use my phone so much that I've neglected non-screen time activities like reading or even playing board games. On the other hand, I got fed up of looking at people's picture-perfect pictures. It was also the January blues, the third lockdown, and isolation put together. Let's just say I got fed up enough to actually do something about it. Instagram has been my biggest weakness for quite some time now, so I made the decision to stop using Instagram for 24 hours. I knew going cold turkey wasn't going to help at all, so I consciously made the decision at the beginning of the week to stop using Instagram on Friday night and then stay away from it entire Saturday, and I can go back on it on Saturday night or maybe even Sunday morning. If you're removing something, you have to replace it with something else. Otherwise, it's so easy to revert back to your old ways out of boredom. So I was gonna spend a good couple of hours reading on Saturday morning, and I wanted to spend some more time decluttering on Saturday afternoon. So I thought that was gonna keep me busy, and I also wanted to delete Instagram Friday night just to make sure I didn't accidentally click on it. Come Friday night, to my surprise, I didn't even have to delete Instagram. I just didn't have the urge to click on it, to scroll through it, to look at other things and everything like that. Saturday morning, I spent a good couple of hours in bed reading, and afternoon, I was decluttering my kitchen as I planned. And it just felt so good. I never once had the urge to go back to Instagram at all the entire day. Maybe because I had my entire mindset ready and prepared for that day. By the end of Saturday night, once I had finished all of my plans for that day, I didn't even feel like looking at Instagram. I didn't miss it at all that day. So what happened was 24 hours became 2 days, 3 days, and it extended to 8 whole days. I stopped using Instagram on a Friday night, and I only logged back into it the following Sunday afternoon. And that too was purely because I was managing another page on Instagram for that week. What surprised me the most was that even when I was taking a break on Saturday, I didn't feel like scrolling through my phone. All I do on my phone is usually Instagram or maybe play Sudoku. That's the only game I have on my phone and nothing else. But you know, you get into the habit of scrolling through your phone and just randomly looking at something. I didn't do that. Saturday night, I spent more time reading and just doing other things at home. I somehow developed an aversion towards my phone. In fact, the entire day, I didn't even reach up for my phone, even when it was beeping non-stop. I stopped using any kind of social media, and I even stopped looking at text messages and responding to text messages. My YouTube videos for that 2 weeks was already scheduled to go up ahead of time, so I didn't even have to log on to YouTube to do that. I realized that ignoring my friends and family was a step too far. But sometimes it feels like it's a social obligation, as if it's an unwritten law that you have to respond to someone immediately. My mind knew that I was taking the time and I needed that time, and I just let that be. Eventually, I did look at my phone from time to time and responded to some somewhat urgent messages. I mean, let's face it, I'm not the Prime Minister of United Kingdom, so I don't have anything urgent that I have to respond to immediately anyways. 2 weekends that I was off social media, I spent my time decluttering the kitchen for one weekend and my storeroom the other weekend. I was extremely surprised by the amount of space I actually had in my kitchen. For a very long time, I thought I've outgrown this kitchen, I need more space, I haven't really got any pantry space, anything like that. But once I decluttered and got rid of all of the expired stuff in my kitchen, I had plenty of space. But I was so upset with how much food I was throwing out. I just didn't even realize I had so much, and I wasn't doing the clear out that I should have regularly. But eventually I got to it. The storeroom didn't make so much of a difference, but I still threw out so many empty boxes that I kept in there. I have no idea why, but we have so many Apple products boxes in our storeroom. We never use it at all. You don't need it the minute you open it and take out your Apple products. That's all you need, not the boxes. But yeah, we still kept some of the boxes. I got rid of so many things. I eventually got rid of a bag full of plastic bags that I was gathering for years and years and years, hoping that I would need it for some time. I mean, I've had it for about 4 or 5 years now and I've not had to use it at all. So I thought it was high time I got rid of it. I managed to organize a little bit more in the storeroom. Now I know where everything is. It probably looks as if it is still in a mess, but it's an organized mess and I know where things are in it now. One of the reasons, or rather one of the excuses I have of wanting to spend so much time on Instagram is because I have this fear of missing out. You know how you keep in touch with all of your friends and family all over the world at the moment through social media? I feel like if I miss someone's stories, I don't really know what's happening in their life anymore. But clearly, in that week that I didn't use social media, I didn't miss it at all. It actually felt peaceful. I didn't feel pressurized by looking at everyone else's stories and posts. And I wasn't even pressurized for over-consuming or not contributing anything at all. It even felt liberating that I was set free from someone else's carefully curated grid. I mean, I do it myself. I definitely plan some of my stories and I plan some of my posts that I put online. I just cannot stand doing things in a random order. I either do it in an orderly manner or don't do anything at all. The 1 week that I was off, I realized that no one really cares if I'm following through with their lives or not. I also realized that I'm not missing out on anything. I just need to learn to switch off and live in my own reality. When I logged back into Instagram, I found that I was put off by the scrolling myself. I no longer felt a connection or a sense of belonging in Instagram and I didn't want to catch up with everything at all. I also suddenly realized that I couldn't connect with so many pages of people that I was following. So the first thing I did was go on a mercilessly culling spree. I unfollowed and muted so many pages that no longer connected with me because it didn't serve its purpose anymore. I might have followed them long back, but I no longer connect with them, unfortunately. I'm happy to report that it's not actually a rash decision at all. After so many weeks now, I still feel the same. I just don't feel the need to have to spend so much time on Instagram anymore, and I don't feel the need to look through every story or every post. It's so important to free yourself from someone else's expectations. Don't let social media define you. And don't be fooled by someone else's grid or even Instagram stories. Chances are, 9 out of 10 times, it's not even true at all. Nobody will want to put up upset pictures or unhappy pictures of themselves. Maybe there are a few honest ones who would put up a happy picture but would use a caption to explain that they are not in a good place or that they are struggling. But it's not the same, is it? But no one is obliged to ever do that. As much as I am real in person and online, I'm not going to put up a picture of myself being upset about something. Why would anybody want to do that? We only want people to see us in the best light. Before it becomes more rambly, I'm just going to stop myself here. I hope this serves as a reminder to you, as it has for me, that we just need to learn to love ourselves. We need to learn to be with ourselves in reality and with people around us in reality. I know it's difficult given the current circumstances with lockdown and restrictions, but where there is a will, there is a way. It will definitely help you appreciate and love yourself even more. Moving forward, I'm definitely going to implement no social media weekends and restrict the amount of time I spend on Instagram and other social media during the weekdays too. I've also come to realize that I don't need to be so carefully organized with my grid or even my stories. It's not going to kill me for being out of line with my OCD-ness once in a while. I would encourage you to do the same too. Not using social media when you're busy is different from intentionally stepping away from it. I would recommend that you try to intentionally step away from it. That's all I have for today's video. Don't forget to subscribe for more nuggets of wisdom and social experiments from me. I will see you again in the next one, and until then, stay safe, stay healthy, and remember to always prioritize yourself and love yourself. Bye!